And joining us now is the legal counsel of former Corrections Bureau Officer in Charge, Rafael Ragos, Attorney Michael De Castro. Attorney, good afternoon and welcome to the program.
Good afternoon. Thank you for having me, Rain.
Mr. Ragos's testimony is the reason why that case, those cases against Senator De Lima are still alive. What pushed, it also pushed that Muntinlupa judge to bring it to trial. Why is Mr. Ragos retracting his statement now? What prompted it?
Well, Rain, the vindication of a burdened conscience has no expiry date. And his statements implicating Senator De Lima has been weighing on him for the longest time. And as he himself stated in his interview with ABS-CBN, he wanted to come clean. He could not live with himself having to live with the knowledge that 5 years of illegal detention is on him.
Mm. 5 years. Your client claims there are threats of him being arrested, being engaged in the drug trade. Who is making the threats and for what?
Well, according to him in his affidavit, which he executed last April 30, it comes straight from the former DOJ secretary and some prosecutors. If I may quote some portions of this affidavit, he says, it says here, mag-execute ka ng affidavit, mag-corroborate ka sa statement ni Ablen. Kung hindi, alam mo naman kung ano mangyayari. And so, given too that he was being detained at the time, you can only imagine the level of duress he was working under.
But who issued that? Is that a text message to him? Who issued that? Is that former Justice Secretary Vitaliano Aguirre?
Yes. In former Secretary, DOJ Secretary Aguirre stated it to him.
Attorney, we seem to be
we can't
hear your audio at the moment. We seem to be losing signal. Can you hear us?
Yes, I can hear you.
Attorney? All right, we'll try to bring back Attorney Michael De Castro in a moment. But right now he was saying that the reason that Rafael Ragos had actually recounted that his claims against former Justice Secretary De Lima had been that he had been had a burdened conscience and he had wanted to come clean for the longest time and clear De Lima after she's been detained for the last 5 years. He was also saying that it was former Justice Secretary Vitaliano Aguirre who issued threats against Ragos so that he can come clean against, or rather, he can continue with the alleged allegations against De Lima in their participation in the illegal drug trade. Now, Attorney De Castro, are you back?
Yes.
All
right. I'm here.
All right. Good to have you. Did he receive any money or any incentive for making those claims against now Senator De Lima?
Well, according to him, he only receives threats. And he hasn't received a single cent.
The recantation now, did Mr. Ragos receive any form of remuneration or incentive to recant his testimony?
I don't believe so, and I don't think so.
Did Mr.
Yes, if you look at his interview himself, that interview, it will show how candid Mr. Ragos is, how straight his answers are, and that the fact that the only reason he's recanting on his statements now is that he wants to come clean.
Did Mr. Ragos ever have any links to Peter Ko?
I believe Mr. Ragos answered that in the interview. And he said, if I remember correctly, that no, he does not. And he does not have any personal knowledge of any illegal activity, but he has his own suspicions. But whatever suspicions those are, he can only surmise.
Would Ragos be privy to anyone else who in the Bilibid drug, among the Bilibid drug lords, and were coerced into testifying against De Lima?
I do not think he is. I think he states outright that it's beyond his personal knowledge whether other witnesses were coerced. The only thing he can testify to is what he heard, what he experienced, and the duress he himself suffered.
Mr. Ragos was placed on floating status at the Bucor for his involvement in the case, without any charges being filed against him. He lost income since 2016. He was implicated in the drug trade anyway, so why would he make those claims in the first place? Right now, he's a witness. Can we know where he is at the moment?
Well, of course, I can't tell you for his own safety. But as to your first statement, why would he make such statement? We already answered that. It was under duress. His affidavit recanting these prior statements attests to those acts of coercion he suffered. Beyond that, too, he was co-accused. And so, if I understand correctly, he was invited to become a state witness in order to be let off as a state witness. He had to agree to making these implicating Senator De Lima.
And now that he is saying he had lied before, why should his recantation be trusted this time?
Well, he himself says it. He doesn't need anyone to believe him. He is answering only to his own conscience, as we all are. And he has no ulterior motive. This is just a man answering to his own conscience.
Is he with his family right now?
I have no knowledge.
The testimony, attorney, seems to highlight to a mutual distrust of former NBI agent Jovencio Ablen Jr. Have they spoken since the House hearings, and can you describe what kind of relationship they might have that they are implicating each other more deeply into the drug trade, including in this latest affidavit?
I'm afraid I cannot answer that. I have no knowledge as to their prior relationship or continuing relationship.
Mr. Ragos also implicated quite a number of witnesses, if not accomplices, in this perceived frame-up of former Justice Secretary De Lima. Has Mr. Ragos been able to speak with these people that he mentioned in his meeting in Soler to begin the whole process of the false testimony? Or has there been any reaction from their camps that have been transmitted to you?
None yet, but you're right. These implications are worrying, to state it very lightly, because they attest to the level of risk a truth-sayer has to go through, and it attests to just how much danger there is for someone who is in Mr. Ragos's position to say no. It's very difficult.
This recantation, attorney, seems to show a pattern that witnesses had been coerced to testify against De Lima, and an orchestrated effort against her that's been actually pointed out by the lawyer of De Lima. Now, after the recantation of drug lord Kerwin Espinosa, and now by your client, many would see this as an orchestrated effort to bring down De Lima. Does the buck stop with former Justice Secretary Aguirre, or does this go all the way up to Malacañang?
Well, Mr. Ragos himself states that one of the prosecutors did tell him, and I quote, "Magtestigo ka ng mabuti, minomonitor ka ng Malacanang." As to where exactly this stops, Mr. Ragos himself says he doesn't know. All he knows is it was former Secretary, DOJ Secretary Aguirre, who told him to execute that affidavit, those affidavits rather.
Attorney, what is your next step for Mr. Ragos? Will you be filing the recantation in court? And if so, how and when?
Well, this affidavit will be made available to the lawyers, to the defense lawyers of Senator De Lima, if should they wish to have access to it. It can also be used, in fact, and I invite you here to think about this. It can be used, in fact, to check prosecutorial misconduct. I mean, there are statements here showing very clearly how some prosecutors are creating their own evidence. I mean, they are the Department of Justice. Is this justice?
Would you be willing to, Mr. Ragos be willing to testify for Senator De Lima if called upon at this point? Will he be calling for her freedom? And would he also urge the DOJ to reinvestigate the case and withdraw the charges against De Lima motu proprio? More importantly, to investigate their own ranks.
Well, to answer your first question, the execution of his affidavit itself should show that he is willing to go on the record as to his recantation. As to calling for an investigation, yes, of course, there should be an investigation, but whether such an investigation will have any fruitful outcome, that there's much to be not hopeful for. But we hope and we urge the DOJ to investigate its own rats. I mean, who exactly will prosecute these erring prosecutors? Will they even prosecute their own?
Attorney, when was the last time you were able to speak with Mr. Ragos? May we know what his disposition is? Did he say that he was tired of perhaps being in hiding as a witness?
For his own safety, I can't reveal when I last talked to him. But as to his demeanor, as to his how he is, he has the aura of a man who is finally at peace. That's what I can say about him right now.
All right. Attorney Michael De Castro, legal counsel for Rafael Ragos. Grateful you could join us today. Thank you so much for sharing your insights with us. We appreciate it.
Thank you, Dane. Thank you.